everyone, Alex Dunn here, and today I am going to be addressing the question of whether now is a good or a bad time to query. We are, of course, in an unprecedented global situation, and a ton of things are shut down. Businesses are shut down, most of us are stuck at home, people are having to do childcare, and generally it feels like everything is on fire. In fact, in publishing specifically, there are a ton of what are called austerity measures in place currently. Certain publishers are furloughing employees, others have done layoffs, though I heard that those layoffs were already planned and then had monumentally bad timing in being announced. But regardless, there are all sorts of shifts happening in the publishing industry. Books are being bumped, books that were supposed to come out right now in spring 2020. Some are being moved as far out as an entire year to spring 2021. And of course, our bookstores are closed. I mean, imagine the This Is Fine gif. Like, it's the flames are happening right now. So everyone, we're all like, what's going on? So I'm here to talk a bit about what's going on and how that might specifically impact those of you who are at the querying stage, who are still looking for an agent. Is now a good time to query? I have a lot of thoughts and some information for you that will hopefully help out, including I talked to my own agent about this. So, being completely honest, the answer is both yes and no, thus it's kind of maybe. Things are both business as usual and not business as usual, and in some cases, there are better conditions for querying right now, and in other conditions, there are less optimal conditions for querying. What I mean is, some agents right now actually have more time than ever to go through queries and read material, and in fact, many agents I've seen tweeting, and I'm gonna throw out some of those names so you know who they are actively tweeting they want to read submissions right now, query them, they want some new material to read. Agents are actively looking to read and sign projects right now, in large part because submission hasn't stopped. I know many people who are on submission to editors right now. Spring is normally a pretty big buying season. They're out on submission. I know people who have gotten preamps. I know people who have gone to auction, sold for six figures. Sales of books are definitely still happening. Even though publishing is all working from home right now, they're still reading material, making offers, having acquisitions, meetings, etc. So thus, I know many agents who are still doing submission as usual. They're still working with their clients to prep the materials to send out to try to sell them. And thus, accordingly, they are still going through queries and trying to actively sign clients and build their list. The reason for this is, as crazy as everything is now, publishing has always worked several years out. Books that are being bought right now aren't going to come out more or less until 2022. Some of them might be crashed into 2021, but we're 2 years out already. And it's very realistic, as bad as things are right now, that by 2022, we're going to need a whole new slate of books, possibly different books than might have been bought before this situation, because people are going to be eager to read. They're going to want to buy books again. The shops will be open and people are going to be looking for stories to take them away. People are looking for stories to take them away right now. And briefly, before I talk about how this whole thing is impacting perhaps what kinds of projects you should be querying, I will talk briefly about the flip of that. As many agents as I've seen saying they have more time to read and they want people to query them, I've also seen agents who are encountering the opposite. I've seen a few agents who are closing to queries so they can catch up. Tao Lee is one of those. And there are also many, many agents who are now in a situation where they have to do full-time childcare, and thus they actually have less time to go through queries and read, because suddenly during the day, instead of day jobbing as an agent, they are going between, like so many working parents, they're going between full-time childcare and school and agenting. So there are some agents who actually have less time to read. It totally varies. I've also seen some agents who are, like many of us, in a bit of a reading slump. Many of us are in a weird brain fog because of all of this, which is perfectly normal. It's also likely impacting our ability to write. I've personally found I can do revision, but anything that's writing is a lot harder to do right now. So imagine that impact on agents as well, that some of them just can't read right now. Or Now we're going to talk about the types of projects maybe you can query versus others. They can read, but only certain kinds of books. The number one thing that I have been noticing is that this whole situation is impacting what kinds of projects agents are asking people to send them. I've seen manuscript wish list more on fire than it has been in months. Agents are actively tweeting about their manuscript wish lists, but I'm seeing they want more than ever lighter reads or simply escape reads. So I'm seeing a lot of agents calling for rom-coms, middle grade, thrillers, like high concept thrillers, and less dark, post-apocalyptic, serious books, issues books. That doesn't mean don't query those at all, but definitely do your due diligence. Look up the specific agents that you're interested in querying and see if they've updated their manuscript wish list or tweeted anything so you get a sense of how your particular project might land in this time. But to make it more complicated, at the same time, I've also seen a few agents and editors, because book editors have also been tweeting, hey agents, send me books. Like I said, submission is still happening at most publishers. They're still buying books. There's also people who in this time want to read more or less read-alikes to the crazy situation that's going on. Some people in a time like this gravitate toward darker fiction, post-apocalyptic fiction, science fiction that has viral plots. It really runs the gamut. I find that it's like, it's an either or thing. I don't know exact percentages, but let's say it's 50-50. Half of people are like, no, and half of people are like, yes. I myself have been oscillating between dark fiction and light fiction, but meaning some agents and thus some editors do want precisely those books right now. So it's a matter of doing your research if you do have a book that could potentially land less well in a global pandemic, and being smart and strategic about who you query. Generally, that's always my advice, to be very smart about who you're querying. It's just in this specific time, more than ever, really doing your research about fit and manuscript wish lists is more important than ever. I've recommended it before, but if you don't have a Query Tracker Pro account, now is the time, because you can actually see via their tool where you can see where your query or queries are in the queue. You can actually see who's reading queries and making requests. You can even see some of the genres of those books, so that might give you even more guidance on what agents are actually reading. And you can strategically query the ones who are actively moving through their query inboxes right now. I actually have a whole video on my favorite winning query strategy. That's going to be going up soon. So if you watch this and go, okay then, I'm going to move forward with querying, maybe that video can help you out. But as promised, I want to tell you what my agent said. I texted her and said, should people be querying right now? And she said, there's no reason not to. Just some agents might be slower to respond if they have kids at home, for example. So you heard it from my agent. No reason not to be querying, so you can count her as an agent that you might as well query if you're in those trenches. And I'll tell you generally, if you're interested in my agent, she doesn't like super dark books, so she's definitely not one to send those to, even when there's not a pandemic going on. And then here is a short list of just some of the agents that I have seen tweeting and posting that they do want to see things right now. They are going through their queries, and they've also posted specific manuscript wish lists that you should take a look at. So some of those agents are Beth Phelan, Pete Knapp, Caitlin McDonald, Jessica Faust of Bookends. I've actually seen multiple Bookends agents who are definitely actively going through their queries, and Uwe Stender. Those are just some that I saw today and in the last few days actively tweeting, but there are many more. So it's all about doing your due diligence of looking up the agents that you're interested in querying and kind of getting a feel for whether they are right to query in this time. Let me know down below in the comments any questions you have about this. I'm sure we all do. It truly is a weird time. I will say that personally, I have been helping a writer query. She started querying 3 weeks ago, and she has had a pretty good request and read rate. Based on my experiences helping her, I have definitely noticed select agents requesting faster and reading faster than ever. So based on that, I say you might as well try querying. And give this video a thumbs up if you like it. I will make more of these kind of industry-focused videos. And if you're not already subscribed to the channel, go ahead and do that. I post new videos 2 to 3 times a week. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching. And in this case, happy querying.